Welcome everyone to another service on the Sabbath, Saturday, October 29th, 2011. We are going to begin with praise and worship. A very, very special praise and worship this morning. Let me tell you a little story. I was coming home from work, really feeling down. My heart just weighed so heavy. Now, I'm a working pastor and I don't have a lot of money. Nowhere near what I need to do. And I have one vehicle. It's a 1994. It's an older vehicle. And now the engine's going out. And it takes me 45 minutes to get to work, 45 minutes to get home. And it's blowing blue smoke, so I believe the engine's just tired. A lot of miles. And Sundays I go to the inner city and I try to bring food and the people in need. And I was really down in the dumps. Then I started all the way home thinking, what am I going to do? Like, my only vehicle is breaking down. And then I start thinking about my children, and they're all grown up, and my boys aren't too far away, but my daughter, she's on the other side of the state, my beautiful blonde-haired little girl, and my two grandsons, Neil and Jacob, and I taught them all to be independent, and she put herself through nursing school, and she's so far away. We communicate, but, you know, holidays we get together. But I just started really being down, missing them, worrying about, now what am I going to do? So I was really, my heart was just heavy. I come home last night, and I get on YouTube, putted the old 94 Jeep to the curb, and what's the first video I come across is Nicole, our dear, dear, beautiful Nicole, our faithful watcher. And she dedicates a video to me. She made a video for me. And we're going to play that for our praise and worship this morning. Because as bad as I felt, it lifted me. It lifted me up. It lifted me up into the arms of my Father. And Nicole, I cannot tell you how much that video has meant to me. And how I am blessed by it. And I want everyone here to be blessed. Are you ready for praise and worship? Stand or be seated, however you're comfortable. Just give all the glory to your Heavenly Father. Give Him all your love and go to Him. Very special video from Nicole. And are you ready? Are you ready for praise and worship this morning?
Hopefully this works. I'm using a different camera, which is duct taped to my computer, in an effort for the sound quality to be a little bit better. I'm doing a video where I'm going to be singing now, but this is for someone special. This is for Pastor Dave, who holds a very special place in my heart. He's one of the faithful watchers who has, from the very beginning, really drawn me into becoming a watcher, and he just has such a heart for the Lord, and he has mentioned that this song is a song that he really loves, and so I've always had the intentions of learning it so I could sing it for him. So it's How He Loves Us, and it's a Kim Walker cover. So this is for Pastor Dave. This is for you, Pastor Dave, and I hope you like it. There is a lot of instrumental. If you know the song, you know what I'm talking about, so if you can just bear with me, that would be great. And I'd love to sing it. So here we go. This is for you, Pastor Dave.
Thank you, Nicole. Thank you. I love you, Nicole. I love each and every one of you. Open your heart to Him. Feel the Holy Spirit.
He is jealous for me. Love like a hurricane, I am too. Bending the knee, the weight of His wind and mercy. And all of a sudden, I am unaware of these afflictions, eclipsed by glory. And I realize just how beautiful You are and how great Your affections are.
Can you feel the Holy Spirit today? Can you feel the Holy Spirit's presence today? In your room, in your home.
Pastor Dave, thank you so much for everything you do. I know you do everything for the glory of our King. Because you love Him. Because He's loved you first. And you know personally how much the Lord truly does love us. Thank you so much for everything that you do. May the Lord bless you and your family. And I can't wait to shake your hand on that amazing day when we are caught up in the air to be with our King. Thank you for everything you do, Pastor Dave.
Thank you, Nicole. Thank you. Could you feel the presence of the Holy Spirit no matter where you are, whether you're in your kitchen, your living room, or... Could you feel the presence of the Holy Spirit? Thank you, Nicole. When we meet in the clouds, no handshake. You're going to get a a great big hug from Pastor Dave. You really lifted my, I was really down. You really lifted me up to my Father. And thank you, Nicole. I want to remind everybody, I'm overwhelmed. I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. Next Saturday, our Sabbath, our service on the Sabbath, occupy closets, not Wall Street. While the world is in protest, we will be in prayer. Spread the word. Christians around the world occupy closets. Chad Vic Hockey, 34, his Salvation Movement, join the movement. His new channel is the Salvation Movement. So many Christians in the end times coming together. So remember next Saturday, and we're going to have communion. So make sure you have a small glass of wine and grape juice and some bread. Next Saturday, November 5th. Remember, I'm overwhelmed. The 5th of November. No matter what weekend is upon us, we know what this weekend is. It doesn't matter. God reigns. He reigns every day of the week, every weekend, every single day. Halloween weekend, let's take a look at maybe, what does the Bible say? We'll look at some verses. We'll look at the evils of the world and palm reading and sorcery and witchcraft and psychic reading. And we'll take a look at a few scriptures real quick. Oh, I'm overwhelmed, Nicole. Let's look real quick at Ephesians 5, verse 7 through 12. Don't participate in the things that people do. For though your hearts were once full of darkness, now you are full of light from the Lord, and your behavior should show it. For this light within you produces only what is good and right and true. We don't need to participate in such things as wanting to know our future and having our palms read and who are we gonna, you know. A lot of people will go to these psychics and they want to know, are they gonna meet the love of their life? Put it in the hands of your Heavenly Father. And mediums and wanting to talk to the dead, do you see how demonic that really is? Well, we'll look at one more. I'm overwhelmed. Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 10 through 12. For example, never sacrifice your son or daughter as a burnt offering, and do not let your people practice fortune-telling or sorcery or allow them to interpret omens or engage in witchcraft or cast spells. So many today, dear beloved, are under spells, demonic spells, or function as mediums or psychics, or call forth the spirits of the dead. And we're going to touch on that either later today or tomorrow with the crystal spells. Don't allow them to call forth the spirits of the dead. Anyone who does these things is an object of horror and disgust to the Lord. An object of horror and disgust to the Lord. Now I want to talk to you about, we've got a lot of prayer requests, and I'm so filled with the Holy Spirit, I don't know how much I can go on. If I was in my own church, I would probably turn it over to somebody else. Nicole, you filled me with the Holy Spirit today. Hell is real. You don't just die, and when you're dead, you're gone. You will be judged, and according to your fruits, and you will, if you have not given your life to the Lord and lived a godly life and accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven, and there is nowhere else. There is no in-between. Many doctrines will preach a holding place, a purgatory. Don't be deceived. There's only two options, heaven and hell. And hell is real. It is a real place where you will, your skin, your flesh will burn. You'll smell the burning of your flesh. And I don't know if you've ever smelt that horrific smell. And you'll never die. You're already gone, but you will be in torture and agony for all eternity. So your eternity is up to you. Will you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior and have eternal life or eternal hell? Eternal life with the Heavenly Father, where no more pain, no more suffering. When the hand of your Heavenly Father will wipe away every tear from your eye. Or, it depends on the life you lead here on this earth. Then what is your destiny? It's not too late to give your life to the Lord. You can repent of your sins right now to your Father. You and your Heavenly Father, right now. Ask forgiveness right now. Father, I come to you a sinner. I ask that you forgive my sins. I am sorry. I know that your only begotten Son died on the cross at Calvary. And Jesus, I love you, and I ask you this day to come into my heart. Dwell within me. Dwell within me. And be the Lord over my life. That's all you have to do. Father, I come to you today, a sinner. I repent of my sins. I know that you sent your only Son to die on the cross at Calvary so I could have eternal life. Jesus, I love you. I ask that you come into my heart today, that you dwell within me. I ask that you become the Lord over my life. Will you accept Jesus? Will you play this back and say them words and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior? And let's take a look at a few verses regarding hell. I've got so much to get through. I'm going to try to get through this quickly. And many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life and some to shame and everlasting contempt. As we look at this weekend, this holiday weekend, if you want to call it a holiday, and people are dressing as devils and monsters, and hell is real. Do you understand the reality of hell? Matthew chapter 5, verse 22, "But I say to you that everyone who is angry with his brother will be liable to judgment. Whoever insults his brother will be liable to the council. And whoever says, 'You fool,' will be liable to the hell of fire." To be careful. We have to be careful, friends. Let's look at the book of Matthew again. Matthew 10, verse 28. "And do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell." Hell is not a made-up place, and there is no purgatory. You've got one. You've got two choices: heaven or hell. And we're at the point now, you need to decide today. Send me a personal message. Saved or help. Help or saved. And let me give you word and scripture. And let me guide you through the words. Give your life to the Lord. You can do it today. You can just play this video back and repeat the words that I said. And let's look at Mark, the book of Mark. Nicole, my goodness, I'm overwhelmed. Chapter 9, verse 44. "And if your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life crippled than with two hands to go to hell, to the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life lame than with two feet to be thrown into hell." We're going to go real quick, so I don't run out of time, to prayer requests. And I'm going to ask that we all pray in agreement. I'm going to begin with the Our Father, and then I'm going to go to prayer requests and remind reminder. Send me your prayer requests if you want them read for next Saturday's service on the Sabbath. Occupy closets, and we will have communion. Bow your head in prayer and remain in prayer and keep your eyes closed in prayer as we begin our prayer requests with the Our Father. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. Lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Okay, let me see. This is from Samuel. Help. Hi, Pastor Dave. My name is Samuel, and I was wondering if you could pray for me on your next video. I am a believer in Jesus Christ. I have been my whole life. I am 21 now. I believe God has called me. I received the Holy Spirit when I was 14 years old. Basically, I need prayer. I don't know what else to do or what to do or what to feel, rather. I know we are all sinners, and if we accept Christ and ask forgiveness, we are forgiven. It's kind of embarrassing, but my biggest things are porn, tobacco, and the way I talk, cursing. I love God with all my heart, and my big problem is I knowingly sin when I watch porn or use tobacco. I know I'm sinning before I even do these things, yet I still do them right after I ask for forgiveness. But I still feel guilty and ashamed. I'm really letting the Lord down. I don't want to do these things. This is Satan, Samuel. This is Satan doing this. You're not doing it. You are allowing Satan to come into your life to cause these thoughts and these actions. Thoughts become action. And you are allowing this. We're going to pray for you. We're going to pray for you, Samuel. But you've got to make a decision. Just like heaven and hell, Samuel, you've got to make a decision. Are you going to listen to the fallen one? Or are you going to listen to the one that has risen? The one that reigns. The one that reigns supreme. You say you've given your life to the Lord. Repent and give your life to the Lord. And know when these feelings come upon you, it is not. It is Satan. And put on your full armor of God. I do this every day of my life. I lust after women. I commit adultery in my heart. Excuse me. I'm so ashamed of these things. I know the Lord and He is my God, but I can't seem to stop. Well, we're going to pray for you today, Samuel. Everyone, if you would, we'll do a silent prayer. Because we know the need. We know the need. And Samuel, we are going to pray for you. Heavenly Father, we lift up Samuel to you this day. We ask that you cover him with the blood of the Lamb from head to toe. That he feel the presence of the Holy Spirit. That he feels the presence move through him right now, right here. Satan, we cast you out. We bind you. All spells that have been cast upon our brother, we rebuke in the name of Jesus. We bind all spells, all evil, all demonic possession. We bind and we cast into the abyss. Heavenly Father, we ask that it be your will. Send angels around Samuel to protect him. When he has these thoughts come upon him, we ask that the Holy Spirit just overwhelm him. Fill him with the Holy Spirit. And all spells, all demonic thoughts, you cast into the abyss. This we do. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Our next prayer request. I'm overwhelmed today. This is from our beloved Ginger. We prayed 2 weeks ago for her grandmother, now her mother, whose name is Jenny. We're going to lift Jenny up in prayer. Pastor, please, this is an emergency prayer request for my mom. Is still in California taking care of her two sick parents. They are about to have to be put in an old age home. Well, my mom got bit by my grandpa's dog 2 days ago, and her arm swelled up. She had to go to the emergency room, and they told her that she had poison in her arm going up her arm, and they gave her a tetanus shot and two other shots and told her to watch it, and if she feels pain traveling up her arm past a certain point to get to the hospital. Well, it's 1 a.m. in Texas time. My aunt just called me and told me to pray because my mom had to go to the hospital again, and they had to cut and drain her arm. They told her that she possibly could have MRSA, which is a poisoning of the bloodstream. We are going to lift your mother up. This is from a dog bite. This is Ginger, our beloved Ginger, who 2 weeks ago we prayed for her grandmother, and her mother's name is Jenny. And I want you to pray in silence, pray along with me. Heavenly Father, we lift up our sister, Jenny, to you this day. Father God, you worked a miracle in this family 2 weeks ago. We came together in prayer. Everyone from this viewing YouTube ministry, we prayed in agreement for the grandmother. Now the mother is in dire need. We pray that all infection be gone. Father God, if it be your will, we ask that the Holy Spirit rain down, that the presence, the blood of the Lamb cover Jenny, that all disease, all poison, all infection of the arm, that we rebuke it, Father God. We rebuke it. We cast disease out. We cast sickness out. We cast and rebuke this dog bite, this tainted blood, and we fill her. Father God, if it be your will, fill her, refresh her blood, make her whole. Father God, we hold on to your word, and Jesus, by your stripes, we are healed, and we believe this, and we claim this for Jenny this day, in your precious name. Amen. Couple more. Prayer request, please. Can I ask a prayer for my grandmother Rita and grandfather Joseph, please? My grandmother is recovering from surgeries as a result of a fall where she broke her pelvis. My grandfather Joseph is suffering terribly with pain from spinal and bone cancer. He is not handling it well and taking it out on my poor grandmother. The doctors have said he won't recover or make it past Christmas. So I ask, please, for some prayer. Please, God bless. This is from Andy. We are going to lift up your grandmother, Rita, and grandfather Joseph in prayer. And pray in agreement with me this day. Father God, we lift up your faithful servants, Rita and Joseph, to you, to your loving arms, Father God, and we pray for a miracle. For Rita, who broke her pelvis and is recovering from so many surgeries, and we know, Father God, that it was your hand that guides the surgeon's hand. We pray for all pain to be removed from Rita's body, that she be healed in Jesus' name. And for Joseph, he is suffering, Father God, in terrible pain from spinal and bone cancer, the disease of Satan. And we rebuke this cancer. We rebuke this cancer of the bone. I know, Father God, we are but mere bone and flesh. But if it be your will you allow Joseph to remain with us here for this Christmas season, Father God, and remove all pain. Wipe away the tear from Joseph's eyes as you promised, and let him feel the the presence of the Holy Spirit. Let him have a spirit of love for Rita, a spirit of calmness. This we ask in Jesus' precious name. Amen. I have time for one more. Pastor Day, prayer request needed for my stepfather and my mother. My 80-year-old stepfather is in a state of fear and anguish over a tribulation that his sons are going through, together with his lack of understanding concerning Jehovah and Jehovah and his salvation. It is affecting his physical and mental health to the point that it in turn is bringing great stress to he and my mother. We're going to pray for a lack of understanding. So in order to help them both and honor God by honoring my mother's wishes, I did the only thing I could do, is take a step of faith and made an agreement with my mother that she and I would pray that God would send the Holy Spirit to my stepfather and give him a dream of reassurance and guidance that he would remember and share with my mother, and he would do this without telling them. This would have a major effect on not only my father, but my mother as well. You see, my father has been plagued for the past few years with terrible dreams that cause him to lash out and cry out concerning struggles that take place in his dreams. He almost never remembers his dreams, but they are so that my mother is awakened and is witness to them. So this is the best way that I can think that would honor God, the Holy Spirit, and my mother's wishes. Yeshua has laid before me this path, which rests completely in his hands. Now this is an added request that my mother knows nothing of. Not only I am asking you to pray for my stepfather to receive a dream from the Holy Spirit, but I am also asking you to pray that my mother also receive a dream of reassurance and guidance as well. My stepfather's name is Buddy, and my mother's name is Dorothy. I trust in the name of Yeshua and turn to you, brothers and sisters, for Yeshua says in Matthew 18, 19, and 20, again I say unto you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. For that when two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst of them. And we're going to do a silent prayer. We are going to pray for your mother, your stepfather. We're going to do it silently. We know the need. I ask everyone together, to pray for this family and to do it now. In the name of Jesus, pray silently. Father God, we lift this man to you this day. Free him from the nightmares, from any spells that may be on him. Give them both dreams, heavenly dreams, Father, of you, Father God. Of you, Father God. Fill this family with the Holy Spirit. Father God, if it is your will, send angels around this home to protect this family. Give this father a sense of just a touch of your amazing grace. Break the chains. We ask, Father God, the Holy Spirit is telling me the chains, to break the chains. The chains will be broken in this matter. Fill this family with the Holy Spirit. Fill their dreams with dreams of you, Father God, and your love, your amazing love, your amazing grace. This we pray. We know the need. In Jesus' precious name. We're going to end now. And I want to remind everybody, next Saturday service, Occupy Closets, we're going to have Holy Communion. And if you have not given your life to the Lord, please do so. Please do so today. Let's end with praise and worship. and I love you. And if you are able, go to my website. This is where, if you do not have a church of your own and are able to tithe to the ministry, Trumpet of God Ministries, or if you can make an offering of love to the ministry. I was really upset last night. Even the car is gone now. And I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to lay hands on my car when I'm done with this and pray I can just get through a little while longer. If you are touched by these Sabbath services and if you can help the ministry, please do so. It's greatly appreciated. It doesn't go in my pocket. It goes to try to help the needy. God bless everybody as we end this Saturday. Service on the Sabbath. What a special service. October 29th. God bless you. I love you. Amazing grace. Saved a wretch like me. If he can save me, he can save you.
I was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now.
Tell your father you're sorry. Accept Jesus into your heart. Send me a personal message. Help. Help me. Send me a personal message. Help me. Say the words.
My fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear? The hour I first believed. My chains are gone. I've been set free. My God, my Savior.
Accept Jesus today as your Lord and Savior. Send me a personal message.
His mercy,
unending love.
Unending love. Amazing
grace. I love you. God bless.